About 6 cases were reported during the current outbreak and were mostly reported in the northern part of Namibia, with one death recorded so far. The Ministry of Health, in conjunction with the Ministry of Agriculture, Water and Forestry, have introduced measures to curb the outbreak.
Of all the cases which we had, there was one positive case which was confirmed. There were 3 negative results, including one of the patients who died, and there are 2 results still outstanding. But the case in which the results are still pending, the patients are in stable conditions. That all the clinicians, they are sensitized about the possibility of dealing with a presenting case of Crimean-Congo Haemorrhagic Fever. The case management has been reviewed, and refreshed that clinicians are acquainted with the management of cases of Crimean-Congo Haemorrhagic Fever. The contacts, that is, people who have been in contact with the patient, there has been contact tracing done, and those contacts, they are being monitored. And then, of course, public awareness. The Ministry of Agriculture, Water and Forestry, they are dealing with the farmers, educating them more on the control of ticks, and also how they can apply the acaricides, that is the remedy that can kill the ticks to livestock, cattle, sheep, goats, etc. Especially in the area where these cases have been reported. The cattle herders, those who are dealing with livestock, the slaughter people who are working in the slaughtering houses, animal health workers, public health workers when caring for the patients, for example, in the hospital setting. So this category of people are more at risk than the rest of the population.
Country Director at the Center for Disease Control and Prevention under the United States Embassy has pointed out measures to be taken to prevent becoming infected.
Wearing the protective clothing, long pants when you're out in the fields, light-colored clothing so you can find the ticks easier, checking your body for ticks after you come in from places where you might have been bit, using insecticides on your body and on your clothing where appropriate. Also, the guidance on how to remove a tick is very important. Remove the tick in one piece and then wash the area where it was. Do not cut the tick. Do not squeeze and crush the tick. This makes you more at risk of being infected of any virus that might be inside of it.
The Minister of Health and Social Services is therefore advising the general public to apply preventative measures and seek medical attention immediately when they get bitten by a tick, while farmers are encouraged to regularly control ticks by using pesticides to reduce the tick population among their livestock.